Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Orphea and in today's video I'm going to be talking about Victorian Goth, which is part of the larger Goth umbrella. If you haven't seen it yet, I would highly recommend checking out my What is Goth video that is the start of the subculture series and explains the large way of what Goth is. But now, without further ado, let's get started. Disclaimer, this video series is meant to be informative. I am stating general facts about these niches within the subculture. You do not have to belong to said part of the subculture to appreciate it, nor do you have to limit yourself to liking only one specific niche exclusively. Every single goth or alternative person I know identifies with multiple styles of multiple niches of goth, as well as non-goth subcultures, and that is totally fine. Feel free to leave a comment to this video if you know more about this specific niche of the video and add to the conversation. So, the origin of Victorian Goth. Victorian Goth is actually based on the Victorian era, where it also lends its name from. This was the UK period of reign of Queen Victoria, which was from the early 19th century, so from 1837 to 1901. And yes, I am reading this from a sheet of information, I do not know this by heart. In this period, there was a strong sense of romanticism and mysticism of the religion, social values, and arts. There was a strong resurgence of Gothic fiction. This was originally a literature movement of the early 18th century, which gained more success in the 1900s. There are two remarkable books that we can name within this literature that were actually written in the Victorian era. This was The Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde by Robert Louis Stevenson, and The Picture of Dorian Gray written by Oscar Wilde. The values of the Victorian era in regards to entertainment are highly appreciated within the Goth subculture. Literature, music, drama, opera, circus, etc. The first movement of musical burlesque was also a big part of this era, but also paranormal spectacles such as talking to the dead and conjuring. The music. Opera and classical music are the main music types that you would think of when thinking of Victorian Goth. These were the types of music that were played at the era, but of course there is a modern twist to this with a few bands that release music that is highly appreciated within the Victorian Goth movement. And to just name a few bands that fall under this Victorian Goth umbrella of the now music, the music that is created during these days, are Emily Autumn, Rasputina, Faun, and Deine Lakaien.
Shine in my direction and help me. Won't you lend me your protection and help me? God help me, believe me.
That some of these bands can also fall under other subculture types. A subculture can have multiple musical influences, and a band can have multiple subcultural influences. And then the most visible part of a subculture, the style. Within the Victorian era, corsets, embroideries, lace trims, petticoats, hoop skirts, bustles, crinolines, trains on skirts, etc. were very popular. So for the women, this meant having a tiny waist and very wide hips. So you would typically have a lot of layers in clothing. So if you would start at the bottom, you would have first underwear, then bloomers, then you would have petticoats to give more volume to the skirt, a crinoline or bustle skirt, and then the actual dress or overskirts over that. Skirts and dresses also could have a train that would run along the floor, so you would have a more dramatical effect. Now for women, it was at the early stages of the Victorian era not common to wear heels unless it were boots that laced up, so ankle boots with either button-ups or lace-ups. Now at the end of the era, heels became more of a fashion trend to wear, and nowadays in the goth subculture you can wear any style of shoes, but most Victorian goths that I personally know of that wear shoes under their dresses are slight heel shoes that are more comfortable to wear, or lace-up boots. The jewelry is very ornate with lots of details, lots of intricate details and gemstones. So for example, you would have a very nice and intricate big collar piece that they would wear. Also, rings were very important, and you would see typical filigree elements worked into it. And then finally, most of the time the women would also be wearing gloves. I am not wearing gloves, but the gloves would typically be either lace gloves or satin gloves or cotton gloves that run up to about the elbow or a little bit lower, but that would cover the entire hands. This was to give a more elegant feel. For men, it was expected to wear tailored pants with a blouse on top of it and then a waistcoat or another type of coat. There were tail coats, which have the two tails at the ends, or frock coats that come more or less up to the knee that were typically worn. They would also be wearing bow ties or regular ties, or they could also have a brooch attached to the top of their shirts. The men typically wore less jewelry, but would have a clock or a watch attached to their sleeves, so they would have a chain dangling over it. And this, up to this day, is still a very common look for men into the Victorian goth style. Now, one thing that is very noticeable is that the men would always wear pointed toe shoes with a slight heel. Now, these shoes are nowadays mostly known as oxfords and brogues, the oxfords being plain shoes and the brogues having a decoration at the tip. Then about the color black. The color black actually had a really big importance within the actual Victorian era. It was traditionally associated with mourning and death, and you were supposed to wear the color black during a certain period of time when someone close to you or a bit further away from you died, and there are specific rules that these people applied to the amount of black they wore. And nowadays, Sinister and Dracula clothing are two brands that are very good at representing this Victorian goth style into what they make and what they sell. And then a little bit of a side note about the true Victorian era and the way they wore makeup, because nowadays for Victorian goth you will wear a lot of elaborate makeup, red lips, eyeliner, fake lashes, etc., and it all just goes. But back in the days, the only people who wore these types of makeups were prostitutes. The more high-class women would also have hair updos, but they would tend to keep their makeup as natural looking as possible. They did want the very pale skin, so they would use products to have paler skin, but it was very much frowned upon to say to a woman of a higher class like that you could see that she was wearing makeup. It was a big insult back in the days. So they would always have very natural looking makeup. Nowadays, within Victorian goth movement, you can see people who wear no makeup at all, or like me, have lots of makeup, or even more and more elaborate looks. For Victorian goth hairstyles, it's mostly updos, and I really tried to create a pretty updo. It is super hard, so congratulations to anyone who can pull this off. I really struggled with this. But most of the time you can also have your hair loose. What was done very commonly was curl their hair, and that's one of the reasons why they would always do updos, because they would tend to burn their hair over the stoves they would heat up their heating curlers over. So they would have chunks of burnt hair, and doing an updo could really well hide that. I did not curl my hair today, but I did a very big updo. So I hope this video gave you a little bit more insight about the Victorian goth movement and where it comes from. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I make new videos every week and would love to have you for every single one of them. I am releasing one part of my subculture series every single month, and in the comment section you can let me know which one you want to see next. If you haven't seen the previous videos of this series yet, I will be linking it in the description box. There is the Trad Goth video as well as the introduction video, What is Goth? I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye!